Dear students, we will discuss invertible function and then binary operation in this class. Let's see what an invertible function is. A function f from x to y is defined to be invertible if there exists a function g from y to x such that g of f equal to ix, g composition f equal to x itself, ix means it is identity function x, and fog, f composition g equal to iy. The function g is called the inverse of f and is denoted by f inverse. Suppose the set x is equal to 1, 2, 3 and set y is a, b, c. We define a function from x to y 1 a 2 b 3 to c. Then again a function from y to x, that is g, it will be c 2 3 b 2 and a 1. For an invertible function, what is the condition? There will be an inverse and g composition f equal to ix. So we will find out g composition f. What is f of 1? F of 1 is the image of 1. Image of 1 is A. F of 1 is A. F of 2 is B. F of 3 is C. Similarly, the function g from here to, from y to x, what is g of a? G of a equal to 1, g of b equal to 2, g of c equal to 3. So we will find now g of x. What is g composition f of x? That is equal to g of f of x. That means g of f of 1 equal to g of, what is f of 1? F of 1 is a. So g of a, what is g of a? G of a equal to 1. We got 1. And g of f of 2, g of f of 2 is equal to g of b equal to 2. G of f of 3 is equal to g of c equal to 3. So we got now 1, 2, 3 as g of f of x. That means g of f is equal to, we got x. Similarly, we will find f of g, f of g of y is equal to f of, what is the first term? G of a. What is the first one? F of g of a. G of a equal to 1. So f of 1 is a. F of g of b is equal to f of 2 equal to b. F of g of c is equal to f of 3 equal to c. So we got f o g, f composition g is equal to, see, a b c, it is y. So we got f o g equal to y. So the condition is satisfied. So this is an invertible function. Now if we observe, let's see, all the elements in x have distinct images in y. So what we say for that? We can say that this is a 1-1 function. All the elements in x have distinct images in y, so this is a 1-1 function. And check now, here in y, all the elements of y are images of elements of x. What we call that? It's a onto function. So this function is a 1-1 and onto. That means it is a bijective function. If f is invertible, then f must be 1-1 and onto. And if f is 1-1 and onto, then f must be invertible. Clear? Let's do a problem now. Consider a function f from R to R, real number to real number, given by f of x equal to 4x plus 3. Show that f is invertible. Find the inverse of f. Two questions. One, we have to show that the given function is invertible and we need to find the inverse of f. So what is the condition a function to be invertible? G composition f equal to ix or x itself, and f composition g is equal to iy or y itself. So let's do. What is the given function f of x? F of x equal to 4x plus 3. So let y equal to 4x plus 3. So y minus 3, take this 3 here, y minus 3 is equal to 4x. So what will be x? X will be y minus 3 divided by 4. So we got x equal to y minus 3 by 4. So g of y is equal to y minus 3 by 4. Now we will check whether this function is, we have to show that this function is invertible and we need to find the inverse of f. So what is the condition a function to be invertible? G of f, that means here g of f of x, we have to prove that this will be equal to x. So g of f equal to g of f of x equal to g of, what is f of x? 4x plus 3. F of x is 4x plus 3. So g of 4x plus 3, we got g of y here, y minus 3 by 4. So instead of y here, put 4x plus 3. So 4x plus 3 instead of y, 4x plus 3 minus 3 whole divided by 4. So 3 minus 3 gone, 4x by 4, 4 4 gone, it is x. So we got g of f, we got it as x. So one part is proved. Now again, f composition g is equal to f of g of y. Actually this means f o g means f composition g of y is equal to f of g of y is equal to f of, what is g of y? We got it is y minus 3 by 4. So f of y minus 3 by 4 is equal to f of x, we got 4x plus 3, but here y minus 3 by 4. So 4 into, instead of x, y minus 3 by 4 plus 3. This 4, 4 gone, y minus 3 plus 3, minus 3 plus 3 gone, we got y. So we proved g of f is equal to x and f o g is equal to y. So this given function is invertible. Now what is the inverse? According to our definition, inverse of f, that is f inverse equal to g. So here inverse of f equal to what is g? We got here, we got y minus 3 by 4. This is the inverse of f. Let's see what a binary operation is. A binary operation star on a set A is a function star from A cross A to A. Cross product of A cross A to A, and we denote star AB by A star B. Actually, binary means two. An operation with two inputs. That is a binary operation. Addition, subtraction, multiplication, division are examples. If A comma B belongs to the set of natural numbers, and let's check if addition is a binary operation on this set. If A comma B belongs to N, see the a function a cross a to a cross a. This is an ordered pair, this to that set itself. That means if a comma b belongs to n, suppose take any two numbers, any take 1, 3, and we check whether addition is a binary operation on this set. Take so 1 star 1 star 3, that means we are taking the star as plus. So 1 plus 3 is equal to 4. 4 belongs to the set of natural numbers, so we can say that addition here is a binary operation on the set of natural numbers. This is the way we do problems. Let's do a problem from our book. The question is, determine whether or not each of the definition of star given below gives a binary operation. In the event that star is not a binary operation, give justification for this. I will do the first two questions. The first one is on z plus. It is defined on z plus. What is z plus? Set of positive integers. Define star by a star b equal to a minus b. Here we have to check the subtraction is a binary operation on the set of positive integers. Take any numbers. Take 1 and 2. So what will be a star b? A star b will be a star b is equal to a star b is equal to a minus b is equal to, if we take 1 and 2, 1 minus 2 equal to minus 1. Minus 1 doesn't belong to the set of positive integers. It is clearly given z plus. If this plus is not there, it is a binary operation. Since the set is positive integers, minus 1 doesn't belong to z plus. Therefore, this is not a binary operation on this given set. Let's go to the second question. Again, set of positive integers, z plus, define star by a star b equal to ab. Take any positive integers, 1 and 2. So, 1 star 2 equal to 1 into 2 equal to 2. 2 belongs to set of positive integers. Therefore, a star b equal to ab. Here, ab means it is a product, a into b. I took 1 and 2 as example, so 1 into 2. AB means A into B. So here on this set, this is a binary operation. AB means A into B. The multiplication is a binary operation on the set of positive integers. Let's check this problem. Let star be a binary operation on the set Q of rational numbers. It is natural numbers. It is rational numbers. On the set Q of rational numbers defined by a star b equal to ab divided by 3, check whether star is commutative and associative. Check whether star is commutative and associative. So we need to know what is commutative. Commutative means for every a comma b belongs to the given set, a star b equal to b star a. That is commutative property. Commutative. So let's check what is a star b. A star b equal to ab by 3, that is given. Now we have to prove that a star b equal to b star a. We'll check b star a then. B star a equal to, according to this definition, this will be b a by 3. We know that BA equal to B into A equal to A into B. So this is equal to AB by 3. So we got A star B is AB by 3 and B star A equal to AB by 3. So this is commutative. A star B equal to B star A. So the given binary operation here is commutative. Let's go to associative. Associative means if ABC belongs to the given set, then A star B star C, A star B star C in bracket is equal to A star B star C. equal to A star. What is B star C? B star C will be BC by 3. This is equal to A star BC by 3. Equal to AB by 3. So first let's put AB. Instead of A, it is A. Instead of B, this whole part, BC by 3. This is B. Then AB by 3. So whole divided by 3. This is equal to A into BC. ABC by 3. By 3, so 3 into 1 by 3, this is equal to ABC by 9. We got A star B star C, we got ABC by 9. Now check the RHS part. A star B star C is equal to, what is A star B? AB by 3 star C. This is equal to A star B equal to AB by 3. So instead of A, here AB by 3, then C whole divided by 3. This also we will get ABC by 9. So we got A star B star C is equal to A star B star C. So this is associative. Clear? Let's take the same question, A star B equal to AB by 3, and we will find the identity element here. So how to find the identity element? The condition is A star E is equal to A equal to E star A for every A belongs to X. So what is A star E according to this definition? A star E equal to A implies A star B equal to AB by 3. So AE by 3 equal to A. That means AA gone, E by 3 equal to 1, we get E equal to 3, which is the identity element. E equal to 3. So identity element is 3. So let's check now the inverse. Inverse, the condition is A star B equal to E equal to B star A. So what is A star B? A star B is AB by 3. AB by 3 equal to E got, E we got 3. So AB by 3 equal to 3 implies B equal to 3 into 3 is 9 divided by A. Similarly, what is B star A? B star A is equal to E implies B star A equal to BA by 3 equal to E got, we got 3. So BA by 3 equal to 3. Therefore B is equal to 9 by A. So B equal to 9 by A is the inverse of this binary operation. Hope this is very clear to you. So we'll conclude this now. Stay tuned for a new update. And if you have any doubt, as I say, if you have any doubt, let me know by putting it on the comment box. And we will be going through the more questions, as especially expected questions and the question papers later on. So for time being, we will conclude this class now. And we will start inverse trigonometry function in the next class. Stay tuned.